One is medicine is sort of abdicated. Most physicians know nothing about nutrition. They don't get any training in medical school, maybe an hour or two lecture. And nutrition is going to be the thing that's doing, bad nutrition is what's doing us in. You can just see that people aren't getting the vitamins and minerals, and they're disabling all sorts of genetic pathways in the body, pathways of metabolism. So geneticists are busily isolating, working out genes that are involved with this and genes that are involved with that. There are 400 genes involved with autism, but Rhonda figured out which micronutrients are key in autism, and that's the thing that we need to do, because you can intervene there. You can give them to people and prevent it. So I think prevention is going to be involve different people. It's going to involve people who know some nutrition and can figure out mechanism. And it's the analytical methods are coming fast, so you'll be able to put your finger in a machine, it'll send the result to your iPhone and say, hey, you're short of vitamin K. Nature's conveniently colored it green for you because it's in plants. And so eat something, eat a plate of spinach or kale or whatever, often, because you need to get your magnesium. And it cuts out the docs. It'll make it more individual medicine. Plus, if you have a genetics is really important too. So if you have a polymorphism, an alternate form of some gene, that means that you need more magnesium than the next fellow, or more vitamin D than the next fellow, then you'll want to know that. There are lots of genetic variability, and I think a lot of it's been selected for because of nutrition. So we'll need to know both the genetics and what you're deficient in by analyzing vulnerable proteins that are long-term, not short-term. And that's all going to come over the next 10 years if we can get people to rethink things, which we're trying to do.
Right. I know I was recently looking at my multivitamin, and I saw that for vitamin A, which, as you mentioned, beta-carotene is a carotenoid that can be converted into vitamin A, the vitamin A source was beta-carotene. And I thought, a good percentage of the population has a gene polymorphism that doesn't allow them to convert beta-carotene into retinol, into the vitamin A. Mm-hmm. And so now you have people possibly taking a multivitamin that, they're getting beta-carotene, which does good things in addition to it's an antioxidant and does, like you mentioned, sequester singlet oxygen well. But, you've got these people now that can't convert beta-carotene to vitamin A, but they don't know it. So I think, these analytical methods where we're looking at both our genes and also, measuring vitamin and minerals in blood, measuring proteins that are biomarkers for, cancer or neurodegenerative diseases that are also respond to vitamins and minerals are also very important and, definitely is something that over the next few decades will help us to prevent and live longer.